This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to convert between inches, feet, yards, and miles. Now, before we can actually do a problem, we have to understand how these four units of measure relate to each other. So let's start with that. 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. Another way to say this would be that there are 12 inches in 1 foot. 1 yard is equal to 3 feet. Now, very often yards are expressed in terms of inches, so we can find what 1 yard equals in inches. We can do it this way. If 1 yard equals 3 feet, and each of those 3 feet has 12 inches, then if we multiply 3 times 12 inches, we should get the number of inches in a yard. So 3 times 12 is 36. That's going to be 36 inches. We've also got miles. 1 mile is equal to 5,280 feet. So these are some facts that you should have memorized. Okay, so when you get a chance, make sure you commit them to memory. Now let's go on to a problem. Convert 4 yards to inches. Okay, here's how I'm going to do this. I'll write 4 yards, I can abbreviate yards as YDS, and just to make this clear, I'm going to make that into a fraction with 1 as the denominator. And now I'm going to multiply it by another fraction. What I'm going to multiply it by is the fraction 36 inches, and I'm going to keep that unit of measure, 36 inches, over 1 yard. Now, this fraction equals 1, because 36 inches is the same as 1 yard. When my numerator and denominator are the same, then the fraction equals 1. So all I'm doing is taking 4 yards, and multiplying it by 1. Now, when I do this, the next step I'm going to do is cancel out anything I have in common in the numerator and the denominator. And both of them have yards, so I'll cross out the yards from the numerator, cross it out from the denominator, and now my denominators are just 1s, which means I can just multiply the numerators. That's going to be 4 times 36 inches. 4 times 36 is 144, and the unit of measure was inches. Now let's do this a second way. Let's convert the yards first into feet, and then the feet into inches. See if we come up with the same answer. So once again, I'll write 4 yards, and I'll write it as a fraction. That's not absolutely necessary. And now I want to convert this into feet. So the unit I want to convert it into is going to be the unit I put in the numerator. So, let's see, 1 yard is 3 feet. So I'll have 3 feet as a numerator. I'm converting out of yards, so I'll have yards in the denominator. So I'm going to multiply 4 yards times 3 feet over 1 yard. 3 feet is the same as 1 yard, so I'm just multiplying 4 yards by 1. But then after I do that, I'm going to want to convert feet into inches. Now, there are 12 inches in every foot. So 12 inches equals 1 foot. So 12 inches over 1 foot is a fraction equal to 1. Now I've got my multiplication problem. I can cross out things that I have in common. So I've got yards in the numerator, yards in the denominator, feet in the numerator, feet in the denominator. All my denominators are now 1, so I just have to multiply the numerators. I've got 4 times 3, that's 12, times 12 again is 144, and the unit of measure is inches. So that's 144 inches. That's the same thing I got the first time around. Okay, let's do one more. Let's convert 48 inches into miles. Okay, so I'll start out with 48 inches. I'm going to make that into a fraction. And I don't know how many inches there are in a mile, so I'll have to convert 48 inches first into feet. So let's see. 1 foot is the equivalent of 12 inches. So I'm going to make a fraction where 1 foot is the numerator, because that's what I want to turn my number into feet. And 12 inches is the denominator. That's what I want to be able to cancel out, the inches. And that fraction, again, equals 1, because 1 foot is the same as 12 inches. So it's a fraction where the numerator and denominator are the same. Once I get the number of feet, I'm going to want to convert that into miles. So 1 mile, I'll make that the numerator, is equivalent to 5,280 feet. That'll be the denominator. Now, let's get rid of inches, which I have both in the numerator and the denominator, so I can cancel them out. We'll get rid of feet, which I have in the numerator and the denominator. We can simplify this a bit more. I've got 48 as a numerator and 12 in one of the denominators, so I can divide both of those numbers by 12. 48 divided by 12 is 4, and 12 divided by 12 is 1. And now when I multiply this, I get 4 times 1 times 1 mile. Let's put that down here. So I've got 4. Mile is the unit of measure I have left. And that's going to be divided by 1 times 1 times 5,280. So I've got 4 over 5,280 with this mile as my unit of measure. So let's see if we can simplify this. I can divide 4 by 4. And I know I can divide 5,280 by 4, so let's see what I get. I divide 4 by 4, I get a 1. Dividing 5,280 by 4, 4 is going to go into the 5 one time with a 1 remainder. It'll go into 12 three times, there'll be 0 remainder. It'll go into 8 two times and 0, 0 times. So I'm going to have 1 over 1,320. I'll have that fraction of a mile. Okay? So that's basically how this works. As I said, you have to know the math facts, the conversion facts, before you can do this. Once you know those facts, it's a fairly simple and straightforward process. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.